Hi students, good morning. I hope you all are fine. Welcome to grade 11 business mathematics class. We are learning our second chapter, algebra. So 2.4 exercise, first problem we have completed in our last class. One problem I gave homework for you. I hope you all completed problem number 9. Already I gave the answer for the homeworks. I hope you all completed your homeworks and checked out the answers also. Okay, so let's move to your class today. That is, start from problem number 2. Verify that 8c4 plus 8c3 equal to 9c4. Okay, you need to verify 8c4 plus 8c3 equal to 9c4. Okay, solution. First, what we are going to do is, first, I am writing the formula for NCR. What's the formula for NCR? We have learned already. NCR is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. What's the formula? NCR is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. So we are going to use this formula here. Okay, so let us take the LHS first. What's the LHS here? 8c4 plus 8c3. So now 8c4, for apply this formula, you will get 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into N minus R. So 8 minus 4 factorial plus 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 8 minus 3 factorial. Got it? Which implies 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial, 4 factorial plus 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 5 factorial. Okay? So now we are going to simplify. What is common for both? Shall we take 8 factorial outside? What's the balance? 1 by 4 factorial, 4 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial, 5 factorial. Okay. So next we are going to simplify 8 factorial into, shall we write this 4 factorial in a form of 3 factorial? Shall we write? We can write. But we can't write 4 factorial as 5 factorial. But we can write 5 factorial as 4 factorial. Okay. So 1 by 4 factorial into, I'm going to write this 4 factorial as in the term of 3 factorial. Okay. If you need 2 factorial also, you can write. That one you have learned already. So 3 factorial. 5 factorial, shall we write it in the form of 4 factorial? So 5 into 4 factorial. Okay. So now, shall we take another common outside? So 8 factorial divided by denominator 4 factorial and 3 factorial common. So what's the balance? 1 by 4 factorial and 3 factorial I took common. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. Got it? So 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 3 factorial, that is common. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. Got it? Next step, what is in outside? Outside term is 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial, 3 factorial. Inside you can take the LCM. So 5 into 4, the LCM is 20. Now numerator 5 plus 4. Okay. So what's the next one? So 8 factorial divided by 4 factorial, 3 factorial into 9 by 20. Okay. So now everything is in multiplication. Okay. So now shall we write this 8 factorial into 9 as 9 factorial? Yes. Okay. So 9 into 8 factorial, this 2 you can combine and you can write this 9 factorial. Am I right? Am I right? So 9 factorial means how can you write 9 into 8 factorial you will write. If you need in the term of 7 means into 7 factorial you will write. So same as that this term can be written as 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial. 3 factorial how will you write? 3 into 2 into 20. Which implies 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial. This fully 4 factorial is it right? So 4 factorial into 3 into 2 is it right? So 4 factorial separate into 3 to 7, 6, 6 to 7, 12, 120. Correct? So 120 you got it. So now this term can be written as 9 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 5 factorial. Y means 5 factorial 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Multiply 5 4s are 20, 23 are 60, 60 into 2 is 120. So this 120 can be written as 5 factorial. Okay. So now you can cancel. How will you cancel 9 factorial? Shall you write it in the form of 5 factorial? So 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 5 factorial. So 5 factorial, 5 factorial get cancelled. So one more, this 4 factorial can be written as 8 into 7 into 6. Denominator 4 factorial, how will you write? 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Common terms you can cancel. This is 2. Again you can cancel, again you can cancel. So what's the value? 9 into 14. So 9 into 14 means 14 into 9. 14 into 9 is it right? So 6, 3, 1, 9 is 9 plus 3 means 126. So you got the answer as 126. So 126 we can write as 9C4. How much? 9C4 find out the value. 9C4 find out the value. 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So, this two terms will get cancelled, this will get cancelled, 3, 2, correct? So, 14 into 9, so 126. So, this implies our ages. Got it? Very, very important. 5 mark also they may ask. Okay, shall we repeat it again? Okay, listen, 8C4 plus 8C3. First, what I did? NCR formula. What is NCR formula? NCR is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Okay. So, I used for this formula 8C4, this one 8C3. Then what is common? 8 factorial is common. Okay. So, next common term I took outside. So, each and every step how you can simplify like that you need to think. Okay. So, here 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 take the LCM inside. So here how you can write this in the form of 9 factorial. The reason is you need 9C4. So you must need to bring in the form of 9 factorial. Okay. So that only keep it in mind. And if you simplify, you will get the answer. There are some other ways to do this problem. Okay. To avoid your confusion, I chose this method. Why must? Then only the using this formula you can solve easier. Okay. So I think it is very easy. So you can follow this. Okay, children, I hope you got the idea. Okay, please write down 2 or 3 times. Otherwise, when you are writing for the examination, up to 4 or 5 steps you will write. Afterwards, you can't able to continue. Okay, so please write it and get the practice. Then only it will be very easy for you. Okay, shall we move to next question? Problem number 3 in this exercise. Okay, let's move to the next question. Problem number 3. I'm writing the question. How many cards? When you are going to do this problem, all of you need to know what you mean by card. You have learned already in I think in 7th or 8th standard you have learned. What about card in a circle? 10th standard also you have learned. So maybe you forgot. So because of that, I'm explaining. So it's the circle. It's right. It's the center. Chord means when you are joining any two points of a circle, you will get a chord. Is it right? So diameter is the longest chord. That and all you have. So any two points, if you are taking and if you are drawing, that's a chord. Okay. So that one already you know. So solution. First one line you can write. What do you mean by a chord? Okay. So chord. A chord is obtained by joining any two points, okay, on a circle. If it, when you are taking one circle, many chords you can draw, okay, any two points, using any two points if you are drawing, so you will obtain a chord, okay, so that is chord. So here the question is, how many chords can be drawn through 21 points on a circle? So I said using two points on a circle you can draw a chord. Okay. So here they asked through 21 points. So how you will choose 21 C2? Correct. So using two points you can draw a chord. Yes. So 21 here they gave. Is it right? How many chords can be drawn through 21 points on a circle? So 21 C2 ways. Correct. So total number of chords drawn through 21 points is same as the number of ways selecting two points out of 21. Okay, so what according to the question I wrote, how what they say, how many chords can be drawn through 21 points? So total number of chords drawn through 21 points, that must be same as the number of ways selecting 2 points out of 21. Out of 21, two points you need to select. Is it right? So how many number of ways, total number of chords is equal to how many number of ways? 21 C2. If you need, you can use NCR formula. That is NCR means N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Otherwise, easiest you can solve. How will you write 21C2? 21 into 20 divided by 2 into 1. This are this. Okay. So, this one is very easy. You can write like this. If you need, you can use the formula. Same answer you get. So, what's the answer? 210. That's the answer. Got it? Okay, very easy, is it right? So if you need, you can use this formula. So if you are using this formula R, okay, this R, this you can use. So NCR means here, what will you do? 21C2 means 21 factorial divided by R factorial means 2 factorial into 21 minus 2. That's equal to 21 factorial divided by 2 factorial, 19 factorial. If you simplify, same answer you will get. If you need, you can do this. Better, this is very easy. Okay, otherwise you can use it. Let's move to next part. Question. How many triangles can be formed by joining the vertices of a hexagon? Okay, now I'm going to ask one question to you. How many vertices are there in a triangle? How many vertices are there in a triangle? 3. How many vertices are there in hexagon? Hexagon 6. Correct? So keep it in mind. Triangle, using 3 vertices you can draw a triangle. Is it right? So this is triangle 1, 2, 3. Okay, so they are asking the question, how many triangles can be formed by joining the vertices of a hexagon? So hexagon, how many vertices? I said 6. Out of how many triangles you can, is it right? So 6. See how many vertices you need for triangle. So 6 3 c 3 ways. Got it? So within one line you can write the answer. So we can write here, so there are 6 vertices of a triangle. How many vertices are there in a triangle? Sorry, 6 vertices of a hexagon. Hexagon. One triangle can be formed by collecting a group of how many vertices you need? 3 vertices. So how many ways are there? 63 ways. Yes. So out of 6 vertices in a hexagon, 3 vertices you need to draw a triangle. Okay. Shall we simplify? So 63, how will you write? 6 into 5 into 4 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 6 into 5 into 4 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. So this will get cancelled. Again, this will get cancelled. So how much? 20. That's the answer. Have you got it? Okay, very easy. Is it right? So let's move to next problem. Problem number 5. Out of 7 consonants and 4 vowels, how many words of 3 consonants and 2 vowels can be formed? Okay, out of 7 consonants and 4 vowels, how much? Out of 7 consonants and 4 vowels, how many words of 3 consonants and 2 vowels can be formed? So we need to listen. Out of 7 consonants and 4 vowels, how many words of 3 consonants and 2 vowels can be formed? Okay. So totally out of 7 consonants and 4 vowels, you need to choose a word with the 3 consonants and 2 vowels. Okay, 3 consonants must be there, 2 vowels must be there. Okay, so listen. Solution. So 3 consonants, is it right? So 3 consonants out of how much? Out of 7. And how many vowels? 2 vowels. Out of how much? Out of 4. Can be chosen as how much? How you choose 7 out of 3, is it right? So sorry, 3 consonants out of 7. So 7c3 into this one 4c2. Okay, so keep it as equation number 1. Then one more thing we need to do, that is each group contains how many letters then? So 3 consonants and 2 vowels, is it right? So each group contains how many letters? Here 3 consonants, 2 vowels. So how many letters? 5 letters. 5 letters. So 5 letters which can be arranged in how much? It's not a combination, it's a group, is it right? So 5 factorial ways you can arrange. Okay. So totally, that is required number of words. How will you write? 7c3 into 4c2 into 5 factorial. So 7c3, what's the value? 7 into 6 into 5 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 4c2 means 4 into 3 divided by 2 into 1. 5 factorial, 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay. So common terms, everything you can cancel. So from here to here, then this to this to S. So 7 5s are 35 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Multiply 35 into 6. 36 into 5 is 30 into 4. 3s are 12. 12 into 2 is 24. Okay, let's multiply 25,200. This is the record. Got it? So you understand clearly. So you need to form a from the record, that is 7 consonants out and 4 vowels totally. From the 3 consonants and 2 vowels you need to choose. So that one for you need to find afterwards how many letters are there. So then total 5 letters, is it right? So from a group when you are selecting, what will you do? That's the 5 factorial. So by fundamental theorem of counting, multiplication. Okay, so we will multiply all this and simplify, you'll get that. Okay, let's move to next problem. Problem number 6. If four dice are rolled, find the number of possible outcomes in which at least one die shows two. Listen here very carefully. If four dice are rolled, yes. So in a die, how many faces are there? Last year, last chapter, you have learned in probability. So if it is a die, means how many faces are there? Six faces. Okay, you will play, is it right, in your home? So we will roll a die and we will play, is it right? Now in your mobile phones, you are used to play, yes. What's the name of the game? You know, is it right? So you will play, is it right, using a die. So six faces must be there, is it right? So in one face, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so six. So here, how many dice they are rolling? Four dice they are rolling. Okay, so possible outcomes must be 6 × 6 × 6 × 6. That is same as 6^4. Correct. So that's the first step. Since four dice are rolled, total number of outcomes is equal to 6^4 or 6 × 6 × 6 × 6. Okay. Then number of possible outcomes in which, that is, at least one die want to show two, is it right? So at least one die want to show two means, just you think it. So at least one die want to show two, that is number of possible outcomes in which two, first we can find, does not appear. Okay, so at least one die showing two means it is difficult, we can't find, is it right? So first we can find does not. Okay, then afterwards if we subtract this and that, you will get the answer. Okay, like that you can do. That is number of possible outcomes in which two does not appear. Two does not appear means each and every die, that is two all alone, does not appear. So that is, the remaining is 5/4. So how will you find the required number of possible outcomes? Required number of outcomes is equal to, how will you find? So you need at least one die shows two, is it right? So if you subtract this answer and this answer, you will get the answer. Okay, that is equal to 6^4 − 5/4. 6^4 you multiply and see, that is 6 × 6 × 6 × 6 × 6. Will you multiply? 36 × 36. If you multiply, you will get 1296. 5^4, what's the value? 625. Subtract 1296 − 625. 176. That's equal to 600. That's the answer. Got it? So keep it in mind. Here they ask the question, at least one die shows two. That one directly we can't find. For that does not, you can find. From the total to that does not, if you subtract means, you will get the balance. Okay? That's the answer, 671. Okay. Let's move to the next question. I'm reading the question from your book. Just you go through. There are 18 guests at a dinner party. How many guests are there in the dinner party? 18 guests. They have to sit 9 guests on either side of a long table. So totally 8 guests are there in the dinner party. They have to sit 9 guests on either side of a long table. 3 particular persons decide to sit on one side and 2 others on the other side. In how many ways can the guest can be seated? You need to be do very carefully. 3 particular guests want to sit on a particular side. Okay. So 2 others want to sit as other side. So one side you take as A side. Another side as B. Okay. Just for imagination. So 3 of them want to sit in the A side. 2 of them want to sit in other side. Okay. So what did he do out of 18, is it right? So 18 members are there. So totally 18 of them is there. three persons need A side, two persons need B side. Okay, so from the 18, three of them and two of them chosen the base, is it right? So how will you so the remaining, that is 18 solution. So using this, how will you find 18 minus 3 minus 2, is it right? Now totally 13 guessed. Okay, 13 guessed, out of which we choose. So in your question, they gave 18 guests at the dinner party. They have to sit 9 guests on either side of a long table. Is it right? So, 3 particular person already they decide for A and B. Okay. So, here I have subtracted. So, 13 guests out of which we choose. How many we will choose? So, totally 13 is there. Is it right? Okay. So, we choose. So, you are going to do. Okay. Just I will give that. So 13 guests is there. Okay, so out of which we choose 6 for side A. Okay, so totally how much is there? We choose 6 for side A. Then what is the balance? Out of 13, 6 I have chose for side A, so 7 for side B. Okay, so here what is the combination you will get here? 13 C6, out of 13 C6, here 7 out of side B, is it right? So 7 out of C7 and the remaining must be 7. Keep it in mind. I will have a doubt, why ma'am here 13 is not there? So from the 13 I have chose 6, is it right? So I have chosen here 7 for side B, is it right? So 13 here, 6 over, so remaining 7 must be there. From the remaining 7 we are choosing 7. Okay, so 7 C1, so total number of A's is 13 C6 into 7 C7. Okay, then 9 persons on each side, is it right? So this is your homework today. So 9 persons on each side, is it right? So themselves they can arrange, is it right? So you don't know how they are going to arrange. So themselves they will arrange, is it right? So 9 persons on either side. So this side 9 persons, that side 9 persons. According to their wish they will join. So that is 9 factorial. Here also 9 factorial. So 1 9 factorial into 9 factorial. So totally how will you find 13? C6 into 7 C7 into 9 factorial into 9 factorial. If you simplify this one, you will get the answer. Will you do? Okay, you need to do. Okay, so everything I have completed, you need to take the fair notes. Okay, that's all. So why, how will you write? Totally 18 must be there. Already 3 and 2 they have chosen the place, so that one is subtracted, so remaining is 30. From that 6 I have chosen for side A. Okay, so what will happen? 13 C6, the remaining 7 must be there, that's 7 C7. So when it is an arrangement for 13 members, I have chosen 6 from there, means the remaining must be 7. So out of 7 you will need to take 7, that's all. Then 9 persons are there, each need to sit for one side, is it right? So 9 persons this side, 9 persons B side. So they will choose according to their wish. So 9 factorial, that side also 9 factorial. So fundamental principle using, we'll multiply all this, and if you simplify, you get that. Okay, we do. This is a homework for you. Okay, complete it. Okay, let's move to the next problem. Very, very important. Next one, 3-mark question. Problem number 8. If a polygon has 44 diagonals, find the number of its sides. Very, very important problem. So how many number of diagonals they said? 44 diagonals, is it right? Number of diagonals is equal to 44. You don't know the number of sides, is it right? So let number of sides is CN. Shall we take a CN? Okay, so we know the number of diagonals, that is number of diagonals, we know how will you find the number of diagonals? How will you just imagine diagonals, is it right? So using two points, we'll draw the diagonals, is it right? So 44 diagonals are here. Otherwise you learn as a formula, that is number of diagonals is equal to NC2 minus A. Okay, otherwise you learn as a formula, no problem. Okay, so that is NC2 minus N. The value is given. NC2 minus N. The number of diagonals. The value is 44. Yes. So NC2, how will you write? N factorial. That's the formula for NCR. That's N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Using this. Write down 2 factorial. N minus 2 factorial. Minus N is equal to 44. So how will you write it in the form of N minus 2 factorial? Then only we can cancel. So N into N minus 1 into N minus 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial into N minus 2 factorial. This and that already we have completed. Okay. So minus N is there. So this and this will get cancelled. So what's the balance? N into N minus 1 minus N by 2 factorial is same as 2. Is it right? So 2 into 1 is equal to 44. Now take down the LCM. N into N minus 1 minus 2N divided by 2 equal to 44. Which implies N square minus N minus 2N is equal to 44 into 2 is 88. So N square minus 3N, bring this to this side, minus 88 is equal to 0. Will you do? Factorize N for two values, you will get one is positive, one is negative. So positive value alone you need to choose. So the N value will get. Will you complete? Okay. You need to complete this problem. Okay. So I gave home one problem, half I have completed, is it right? I gave the homework. This one also you need to find the N value. Already 9th problem we have completed. Then 10th problem, problem number 10 is your homework. I will give the idea for you. The reason is from the next class you need to start the next section. Okay. So 10th problem, I am giving the idea, you need to know. A committee of 5 is to be formed out of 6 gents and 4 ladies. Okay. In how many ways this can be done? When first section is at least 2 ladies are included. Okay. So you draw one tabular column like that. Okay. Ladies 4. Gents how much? 6. Is it right? So a committee consists of totally 4 ladies, gents 6. Is it right? So number of ways. Then only it will be very easy for you to write. Otherwise one by one steps you need to write. Okay. So a committee of 5 persons consisting of at least 2 ladies are included. Is it right? So at least 2 ladies means minimum, maximum. Yes, minimum. Yes. So 2 ladies must be there out of 4. Is it right? So for 2 ladies, then for 3, then for 4. So gents 2 you have chosen means here totally committee 5. Is it right? So 2 chosen means what are the balance? 3. 3 here you chose means 2 gents must be there. 4 here you chose means 1 must be there. So when you are writing here, how will you write? Out of 4, is it right? So 4C2 into out of 6, 3. So 6C3. Find out the value. Then here 4C3 into out of 6, is it right? So 6C2 equal to, find out the answer. Then here 4C4 into out of 6, is it right? So 6C1. Each and everything you find out the answer. Afterwards total number of ways when you are finding, you need to add the 3 answer, you will get the answer. Okay, we add all the 3 answer. Then when you are doing the second part also, same like that. Ladies, gents, number of ways. Okay, number of ways. Here in the second part they said this, here ladies 4, gents 6. Okay. So here also second part when you are doing time, the committee of 5 persons consisting of at most 2. So maximum 2 must be there. So 0, 1, 2. That's the thing. So at least and at most you have learned last year. Yes? So at least means 2, 3, 4. Yes? Maximum 4 ladies. Correct? So here ladies totally 4 is there. So at most 2 means 0, 1, 2. So here 0 means 6 must be there. Sorry, 5, is it right? Totally. Here 1 means remaining 4. Here 2 means 3 must be there. So how will you write this one? 0 is 0. So out of 6, is it right? So 6C5. Then this one for 4C1 into 6C4. The last one 4C2 into 6C3. This answer, this answer, this answer. Add all the answer, you will get the answer. Will you complete? So when you are finding this one, you will get the answer as 186. This one, you will get the answer as 186. Will you complete? So this section over. I hope you students, you got the idea. So combinations over. So here and there, that is almost I completed, just calculation alone I left for you. So this 3 problems you completed and complete this one fully. Okay. So in our next class we will start the next section, induction. So because of that I have completed this one today. So So that's a new section, mathematical induction, important section. Okay, so in 12th standard also you are going to learn that. Okay, so it's very, very important. So in our next class we will start the new section. So before that, complete this everything, homework, classwork, everything completed. Please differentiate everything and learn combination, permutation. In your seeing time it will be somewhat confusion. Okay, so please understand the meaning and learn it. We will meet in the next class with a new topic. Thank you, children.